Life is sweet for Peter Andre.
Hello.
He's moving on and concentrating on his career, his kids and his new life.
Yeah, I love you so much.
Come with Pete as he moves forward.
She can't bring me down anymore, man. She can't do it.
Join in fun with the family. Watch his pop success.
Yes, let's go kick some ass. Please don't fall off stage and please, please just sing as well as you just did in rehearsal.
And witness his battles.
My face was just covered in blood.
Yay, so victory.
Don't let the buggers grind you down. Keep smiling. You are a thoroughly decent bloke.
No!
With exclusive access all areas, follow Pete as he embarks on his next chapter.
Whatever wave it is I'm riding, I'm sticking on it. And I'm holding on both sides.
It's Tuesday, the 18th of August, and Pete's in Brighton at his new family home. After the success of his comeback single, Pete's next challenge is to release the new album he hopes will reinvent his music career. Manager Claire is not only masterminding his musical relaunch, but she's supported Pete throughout the breakup and become part of the family.
Right, Pete, you just have a look. These are your album, because it's got to go to print. So can I just show you? They want this as an extra picture.
Yeah, I like that.
And they get in black and white, okay?
Yeah, I like that.
Right, this is the actual CD.
Brilliant, love it. Love that, white. What's the red for?
Because that will be the actual box colour.
Okay.
So it links in with that red. The tracks around the edge will be CD silver.
Oh, very nice. Very classy.
So then it's all silver, white, and the red.
Brilliant.
Family time is precious for single dad Pete, and he's planned a special day out for the kids. Harvey will be joining in the fun, but his mother has insisted he's not to be filmed.
So we're off to the pier. We're going to go fishing with the kids, which would be great fun. Quick. Look. I
spotted that
I
playing with
no,
my
boo.
I
love you. Right, that's it.
With him.
You love him? Uh-oh.
It feels like Australia today, doesn't it? It just does not feel like... I think it's because of where we are too, Brighton being what it is.
One, two, three.
Pete has chartered a boat from Brighton Marina so the kids can try their hand at deep-sea fishing. News of the day has got out and crowds have gathered to wave them off.
Junior, why don't you wave at everyone? Princess, say hello, look. Give me your dummy for 5 minutes. Yeah, we're going to catch some fish, aren't we? Wave, Junior, say bye-bye. Let's see how big fish you want to catch. How big, dude?
This size?
Bit more. Yeah! What about like that, mate? What about like that? I love you so... I can't bear it. I want to eat your nose, but then it'll hurt, and then you'll get upset with Dad.
Oh, Jake, you doing some fishing?
Hold one with this hand, like that.
Yeah,
put it there like that. Right. Hold one like that, and then the other one
Bye. Take care. Nah. Well done.
So what kind of fish do you catch out here?
The mackerel.
Oh, I'd love to catch a mackie. Hey, if we caught a mackerel, right, and we took it to McDonald's, it'd be a mackerel on or whatever.
Luckily, Pete's comeback music career is more successful than his jokes.
You know, with his single, we really wanted it to go top five. He wasn't disappointed about it being number one at all. You know, if you'd have said to Pete 12 months ago that he would have had a top five single, his ninth top five single, and he's ecstatic, and I couldn't have wished for it to have happened to a nicer man than him.
Here we go. Fishy.
Hey, JJ, well done. Look at JJ caught a fish. JJ, well done, butter. Butter? Bubba, baby. JJ, I'm so proud of you, son.
You caught a fish?
Yes, Junior just did.
Junior caught a fish?
Yep.
A little bit disappointed I haven't caught the first one.
Uh-huh.
Maybe because it's England, not Australia. I've always wanted to have a big rod. Where's Jay?
I'm here doing some fishing.
Professionally, Pete's on the up, but the stress of his high-profile divorce has taken its toll on his health.
The other night, I woke up about 3 o'clock in the morning and I was feeling really dizzy. My back of my head was really hurting. I thought, okay. You know, I was thinking, okay, what's, you know, maybe I'm getting a flu or something. Then I started getting a panicky feeling and I got, started hyperventilating. And I was like, please God, please God. And I'm splashing water on my face thinking, you'll be fine, you'll be fine, you'll be fine, you'll be fine. And as I was walking back to my bed, I must have fell unconscious while I was standing because all I heard was the bang. And I woke up, I don't know how long after, and I was just looking up at the sky and I'm going, be calm, you've got to be strong for the kids, you've got to be strong for the kids. I get up in my own time, go to the bathroom and my face was just covered in blood. And on my wall there was a big thing of blood. It's all part of it, man. You go ups, you have downs. I think stress does get to me. It never used to. I'm a very calm person, but that's why the benefit of having my lovelies with me.
And it's one of Pete's lovelies, young Junior, who landed the catch of the day.
Hold it like this, Junior. Go, yay! Say victory! Look at him. He caught his big fish.
It's a big fish. I didn't know you caught one that big.
Didn't you know?
No, is he smelly?
Yeah, he's going to have to... Hey, Junior, say hello. Look. Up there, look. Say hello. Don't act shy.
Thanks, guys. Nice to meet you all. Have fun fishing.
Back on dry land, and it's over to manager Claire's house for a spot of lunch.
It's all right, you can lean in me. There you go, sweetheart. Do you love me? Oh. I love you. The mama pajama rolled out of bed and she ran.
Do you want a sandwich?
Princess is eating and Junior's eating.
Although his divorce from Katie is still making front page news, Pete is making sure that family time is as normal as possible.
Oh, okay. Oh, Junior.
Excuse me, don't
mind. Okay, all right.
Daddy. See me and Julio down by the schoolyard.
See me and Julio down by the schoolyard. Princess, do you want to come on the tramp? Oh, God. All this food's just going to go. How are you doing? For the kids, it's worth it.
Princess, do the laugh. Princess, do really hard.
Do the wobble really hard. Look at the camera and do it. Go.
I love you so much.
Do a really loud.
Pete's found it difficult adjusting to seeing the kids on a shared basis and relishes every minute he spends with them.
In. Out. Feet, you're higher.
Right. Out. In. Out. No, do it until I say. Right. Out. In. Out. Just wait until I say it. In. Out. In. Out. In. Out. In. Out. In.
Oh, you are so cute. You're too cute for school, you are. Go on, go up there. Good girl. Good girl, though. You're doing so well. Go on. That's it. Good girl. Go up there. Good girl.
They're growing up so quick, aren't they?
You are growing up very quick, old boy. You are. That's what I just said. Or are you, was that a question? Go on, then. Jump. Go. Yes.
Coming up, Pete clears off to Sunny Climbs.
We're in for a dippage with Brother Mickage.
And clears out his drawers.
Oh, hello. Haven't seen you for a while. Actually, I've never seen you ever.
It's Thursday, the 20th of August, and the kids are back with their mother. Pete and big brother Mike are about to catch an early flight to Cyprus on family business.
I'm so tired. I'm not awake yet. I haven't had a coffee and so I'm not... I don't even know what I'm talking about yet. Well, I don't normally know what I'm talking about anyway, but that's not the point.
Pete needs a runaround for his new nanny, so the brothers are on their way to his villa to bring back Pete's holiday car. Legally, his car has to stay in storage while Pete's out of the country, and he's required to collect it in person.
So we're off to Cyprus so I can get my car from impoundment, or whatever you call it, and bring it back to England.
And so, but the thing is, instead of just calling someone and saying, can you get the car out and can I send it, I have to personally do it. That's the laws of Cyprus. Do I agree with the laws? No. Can I do anything about it? No.
Since Pete became a single man, his adoring fans are out in force.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you guys. Take care.
Yes, sir. We got all the boarding cards.
As they touch down on Cypriot soil, Pete's hoping to leave behind the problems surrounding his split.
Thank you, guys.
Very nice to see you. Thank you. We're in my motherland. Love it. These lovely photographers, they always know. I asked him how he knew I was coming. He said, I always know.
At the villa, Uncle Michaelis has headed over to give the boys a warm welcome.
So relaxing, it makes you just don't want to leave. Love my home, love it.
So, just got here to Cyprus. First things first, we had our coffee and now we're going in for a dippage.
Yeah. With Uncle Mickage.
We're going in for a dippage. What are we doing now?
We're in for a dippage with Brother Mickage. So we're going to just chill for a couple of hours.
That our coffees.
Then we're going to go for a Japanese. Oh, yeah. In Cyprus. Only I would come all the way to Cyprus to go to a Japanese.
Yeah, game of tennis. Yeah, come on. I'll take this out.
Pete and big brother Mike have become closer than ever over the difficult last few months. And while they're in Cyprus, they intend to have some fun.
Ah, hello, Cyprus. This place always has this character
special
meaning in our art.
Special feeling, even though it's a home away from home, it always You always get that little bit of excitement every time you come here. I like England for certain things, I like Australia for certain things, and I love Cyprus for certain things.
Dude, that's just repeating what you said before.
So what it is,
well, they're all special to me, and you don't have to elaborate. Special. It's like telling a joke and then explaining it like I used to do.
Now, then what I would you do right at this point? You go, dude, you're battering me.
Well, yeah, okay, fair enough.
Jumping down my throat.
All right. That was, but mine was more a joke.
As the boys agree to disagree, Pete takes a call from his management back in England. A national newspaper is preparing to print a story containing personal texts from Pete to Katie.
I've never sent an abusive text to Kate ever. No, I think I was very careful with my texts. I can look back at all of them and I don't think there's not one. Can you hear me? Oh. Not one text have I sent her abusive.
Have they gone to print with it?
No.
What?
No.
What, are they trying to figure out if it's true or not?
Well, Claire said, Claire's got every text. I forwarded every text to her.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that I would have a backup plan. Did I send you some as well?
No.
I've put some on my computer as well.
I'm not calling you a liar, just don't lie to me.
Well, there's nothing there.
Nothing. Sorry. I've not sent any abusive text to anyone. Yeah, but then it goes on the front, and I've got to go and retaliate.
Why are you retaliate, Pete, with lawyers? That's how you do it. And they need to know that. You have made a statement that if anyone does any defamatory statements against you, you'll take it to court.
When they say things that aren't true. And I've got proof, I've got it all here, so. I'm not gonna let it affect me, but what I don't want is things on the front cover that aren't true, and then I've gotta go and explain that it's not true, and then I've gotta prove it, so then it's like I'm talking, and it just doesn't stop. You know?
Next morning, Pete and Mike are on their way to the bonding depot to release Pete's new nanny car. Since Pete and Katie broke up, she started dating cage fighter Alex Reed. But late last night, Pete received numerous text and phone messages from his ex.
She's left me three voice messages singing, completely off key. Singing I Have Nothing, our wedding song, you know? That's why I'm angry, because she's giving it all this large that I don't need Pete, I do what I want. And one thing's saying it, but she actually goes and does it.
Did you reply last night?
No, I did not reply, and I will not reply. But I'm going to keep those, because when she starts giving it the large to everyone, I'm going to say, well, really? Really? Anyway, the reason I'm saying it is for all those people that might say, well, at least she's showing you she loves you. Bollocks, she loves me. She loves herself. That's the problem.
Divorce issues aside, Pete must crack on with the purpose of his trip.
The thing is, there's been a problem with the nanny car in England where, you know, Kay won't share the car, basically, so I'm going to bring mine from Cyprus. This was my car that I had out here, but I'll bring it back so that my new nanny, because we're not going to be sharing the nannies now, I've found my own nanny, so she'll be driving this car.
But before Pete can bring the car back to Brighton, he must sign the legal paperwork and pay the storage fee.
Oh, God bless his heart. Keep playing mysterious girl. God bless him. That's the second time in 15 minutes. Yeah, sir, it's Paddy's coming. I'm gonna get the quad bike out here. Need a quaddie.
Finally, after 4 hours, Pete's given the green light to pick up his 4x4 from the bonding warehouse.
Honestly, all this just to get the car. How long does it take? Just forever. Just press the button. Yeah, this one. That's all right, no problem.
Thank you, dear. Now sit together this way. She said, baby, can't you see? The kids need a nanny car, obviously, so I've come out here now and I'll just send this back. This is perfect for them. Perfect.
With the car out of storage, Pete can make arrangements to have it shipped over to the UK. But for now, Pete plans to crank up the Barbie for all his Cypriot cousins.
Tonight's barbecue is going to be the most finger-licking, scrumptious tasting. Barb, I don't know, I'll tell you in a minute.
Now, where is the bitter bread? Ya supone the bitter? Bitter.
We got chicken, pork, lamb,
rice,
salad,
scotch,
pita bread, which I bought, with some dips, which I bought, and loads of scotch. What more do we want?
Back at the villa, Pete prepares a traditional Greek feast and shows his unusual device to turn up the heat.
What we do is you use the hairdryer. Yes, I know it's pink, all right? And I'm comfortable with my sexuality. There's nothing wrong with a pink hairdryer. Look, you do that, and it gets the fire in all the bits. So when I'll just leave those to carry on, I'm just going to go do some stuff. I'll be back soon.
Pete built this dream home for Katie and the kids and had hoped to spend many family holidays here.
I'm actually just I'm just packing Kate's stuff. This is the stuff that she bought here, so I'm just going to pack it for her and send it back. Yeah, unfortunately, this is the final bit now. I mean, obviously, I've still got stuff at the British home, the marital home, but she will obviously not be coming back here, so I'm just going to make sure all the stuff goes back safe. It's just time to move on now, you know? I did all my sad and my bitter and all that and got through all that. Was tough as hell, but I got through it. So now it's time to just get on with life. As long as I've got my kids by my side, then we're all good. You know, it's weird because what should have really been hurting, like doing all this, surprisingly doesn't hurt like I thought it would. I'm that sure about what I want to do now in my life, and now I just want to move forward and all that, that it's not that kind of hurt anymore. I think this is a very big, this is not a big step, this is a final step. Do you know what I mean? It's a final step. Oh, hello. Haven't seen you for a while. Actually, I've never seen you ever. The dog days are over. The dog days are done. Welcome, welcome, welcome. How are you, cuz?
We're on to a corner.
Tia, feliz.
Do you want to?
I want a bit of.
I love it.
Well,
I just love the simpleness of this family. It's just superb. Ella, Ella, Ella.
Everybody.
His gut is so grown up now.
Yeah?
Wow. Junior loves it. And Harvey loves these. Mm. Absolutely loves them. Princess, she'll eat any.
Well, thank you very much.
It's been a success.
Coming up, Pete's hot property.
Life seems to be moving in a very nice direction at the moment.
And his popularity hits fever pitch.
Look who it is over here!
Pete's back in the UK. Before the split, his career was always overshadowed by his relationship with Katie. But now he's scooped presenting jobs on This Morning and the MOBO Awards. Today he's in London attending a press call for the awards ceremony.
Yeah, I'm just gonna, and then.
What brings you down here tonight?
Okay, well, I had the opportunity of meeting the CEO of the MOBOs, Kanya, and we sat down and we spoke, and she knows how much I've always been a fan of the MOBOs, and she offered me to be a part of this year, so I'm very honoured.
Is this something that you've watched year in, year out?
Yeah, I love it. A lot of people that are in pop music have always been inspired by, whether they're into R&B or hip-hop or pop, we've all been inspired by that style of music, so it's great to see it getting the recognition it deserves.
And I mean, is it just music for you now then? Are you kind
of... No. I've just been given a job on This Morning as a showbiz reporter. I'm very happy. I'm not saying I'm going to be as good
as
you.
We don't need more journalists.
Yeah. But I'm going to enjoy it, you know. I like talking to people.
I mean, you've been also working with Holly Willoughby. She's the new This Morning.
Yeah, I think Holly's going to be great. There'll always be a soft spot for Fern, of course, but I think Holly's a fantastic replacement.
Fantastic.
So I look forward to seeing you this morning, tomorrow morning.
For the first time in months, Pete's able to speak about his work without fielding questions about his private life.
Yourself, you're really busy at the moment.
Yeah, I am. I'm thankfully, you know, the album's just about to come out. I'm just about to do heavy promo for that. But on the other side, TV work's going amazing. And life seems to be moving in a very nice direction at the moment. I can't believe how it's expanded. All these things have happened. And I'm riding, whatever wave it is I'm riding, I'm sticking on it. And I'm holding on both sides. It's weird because I was doing interviews and then they were asking me about, obviously, because I'm going to be doing that showbiz presenting now on This Morning, and I said I'm now going to be on the other foot. And what, hearing their questions to me, now I'm starting to hear it differently because I'm thinking how I would ask somebody something. I'm going to enjoy it.
You got some tips?
No, but I didn't get any from anyone. They all just said don't do it. Of course, because of the fact that they were journalists themselves. But I think it could be quite fun.
Pete's confidence is soaring, and today he's taking his music on the road. He's about to meet some of his growing army of fans and perform a very exclusive gig in Manchester.
Key 103.5 is what I'm doing today. And it's in a street, isn't it?
Yeah, competition winner from Key 103 won the chance for you to perform in their street.
Well, that's really up my street, actually.
And our bass today is in their house.
Get out.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Fantastic.
As well as performing for the residents of Baywood Street, Pete will broadcast live across the airwaves to the whole of the Northwest.
Lovely. So all the people here live on this street.
Oh, only the people on this street can come.
And I think there's next two, and they've all got special wristbands and things.
Oh, how sweet. What?
Pensioner Sandra Carroll will be the envy of all her neighbours as the lucky lady gets to spend the day with the new slimline and single Pete.
I'm in someone's house. I bet you they've made homemade stuff.
How are you?
Good, darling.
Hello.
How are yous?
Hello.
Thank you for having us in your home.
It's quite
it's very
this
lovely.
Is the happy dog.
Yes. Hello.
Oh, that's Jake.
Aren't you gorgeous, Jake, hey? Good on you, buddy.
You've lost some weight.
I have. I have. And you know, I don't recommend how I lost it, but I'm glad I have. But I don't
you look
recommend
well.
How.
You
thank
look
you
well.
So much. I shouldn't have my glasses on in the house. No. Very rude, isn't it?
Okay.
Hello there.
Hello.
I'm Peter.
It's Julie.
I'm
Julie.
Nice Julie. To meet you. Lovely. Do you know, this is my first time I've ever been in a home in Manchester, ever.
Is it?
But thank you for having us in your home. It's very lovely of you. Thank
You're
you.
Welcome.
Sandra shows Pete some northern hospitality whilst her house guest goes in search of the little boy's room.
Where am I? Bathroom's here. Now, this is what you call a bathroom because there's an actual bath in it. That's why I never understand why they call toilets bathrooms, which never have baths in it. But this one actually does. This is a traditional bathroom. Goodbye.
How do you think Pete looked?
I think he looks very well. Very well. I like it with a bit more meat on, though. Mind you, that's me. I like my men with a bit of meat on.
What we do is one looking towards me and then one laughing with each other.
Okay.
Okay.
And then can you do one laughing? You, to make it work, you've got to have a
laugh. We've got to do a fake laugh, even though we genuinely want to, but.
As crowds of excited fans gather, Pete finds a quiet spot to warm up the vocal cords.
Exercise 7, the diaphragm exercise. Ascending staccato thirds.
Do you know, I did have slight reservations about this because you don't know what to expect because it's really different from what we've ever done before. And so you kind of think, I don't know what it's going to be like. But to be honest, it's been really good. And you know, he's been so, so well received. And, you know, everybody's lovely and everyone's really up for it. And, yeah, it's just, it's really good.
Hello. Never know. I mean, my jeans might want to smell nice. You never know.
And it's time for the jeans to make their special guest appearance.
Man.
Your grandma makes an awesome cup of tea, I have to tell you.
Sandra.
Look who it is on my head!
Hello, how are you? How are you?
Hello.
How are you doing? Are you okay?
Do you know, in the last week or two, I've been feeling really good, actually. Yeah, I'm feeling really good now.
There's a lot of nice ladies here from Marvel.
I know.
Day.
Very beautiful.
Look,
place,
a lot
actually.
Of ladies waving at you now.
This is actually a very cool street.
It
do
is.
A lot of you actually know each other, or is this the first time? So is this like one of those friendly neighbourhoods where everyone gives each other cakes on Sundays? Oh, I love it.
Do you want to hear Peter play live?
Can you go now? All right, this is one of the songs of my new album. It's called Ready For Us. And this is coming out September the
14th. Say, lady, I've been thinking about the song tonight. Trying to put these words together so I can get it right.
Ready For Us has an R&B vibe and is one of Pete's personal favourites off his new album.
Thank you. I love you guys lots. Thanks very much. Bye-bye.
Andre Fever has taken over Baywood Street, Harper Hay.
Here's the
and that would be Peter Andre's signature right there. I like it. I'm not washing for a while.
Yeah, it's
unbelievable.
It's something, I mean, the local, it brought a lot of the community together a bit closer, you know what I mean? So.
And I'm dead chuck.
All right.
Having his gorgeous.
And you grabbed all of him, didn't you, when he come out?
Yeah.
Sorry, I should put me out.
Okay.
I like this neighbourhood.
Coming up, pre-performance nerves kick in.
Yes, let's go kick some ass. Please don't fall off stage and please just sing as well as you just did in rehearsal.
And love is in the air in Camp Andre.
Oh my God! I'm so proud of you guys.
It's the 31st of August and Pete's heading back up north to do a special gig in sunny Manchester. Or so he thought.
Honestly, ma'am, it was summer when we left this morning. It was summer until an hour ago when I fell asleep. I wake up. Now that is a spin out. Imagine, that's when you feel like you've slept for days, is when you wake up and the weather's completely different within an hour. That, my friends, can only happen in the UK.
Wow.
Summer? Summer?
Manchester Pride is one of the biggest gay festivals in the country, and Pete is the star turn. He's planned a special set and will perform a new stage routine with backing dancers. Close friend and manager Nicola is here to make sure things go to plan, and she's brought along her girlfriend Ginny to help out.
It finishes at 8:30. After your 30-minute set, it finishes. It's been on for 4 days. This is its fourth and final day, so you are the headline.
Bloody hell, I better be good.
They're so up for it. The crowd's been building. We've been here since about 2, and it's just been building and building and building, OK? There's people with Team Andre T-shirts on and all sorts.
Spotlight is catching you, I see you across the room. So many people around you, I'm trying to make a move. The center of attention, you got me so consumed. You and me can be so hot together. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
After a quick rehearsal, it's time for an anxious Pete to get out there and wow the audience.
Woo! She thinks she's clever, but I'm trying to get at her. She's everybody's question, but I'm the answer. Yes, let's go kick some ass. Please don't fall off stage, and please just sing as well as you just did in rehearsals, please.
Yeah, man, sounding good.
How you doing, bro? Nice to see you, man. You too. Sounds like a great crowd, man. Let's go kick some ass.
Today's a big day for Pete, but Nicola's girlfriend Ginny wants to make it a momentous occasion too.
After your last song,
yes.
I'd like to propose to Nicola on stage.
Are you serious?
I'll
ask Sting to the guy.
One or two things like that.
Pete's now as excited about the proposal as he is nervous about doing the show.
Vocals,
yes.
And I'm loving
nothing
it.
Nothing negative about anyone else.
No,
about you.
God, no.
Just enjoy. Don't go nuts, but enjoy every minute. Perform how you can perform. Let those vocals come out. Okay?
Thanks, Nicola.
You look great. And you look great.
I feel great.
Turn around, let's have a quick look at the back.
This is what they do at all.
First song, The Way You Move, is a club track and a definite crowd pleaser. And he's not even fallen off the stage.
Okay, well, that was a song off my new album. That was called The Way You Move. Okay. This is called Ready For Us, so I hope you like it.
After a fantastic response to his first two songs, Pete saved the best till last, his top five hit, Behind Closed Doors.
I do have something, if that's all right, I want to share with you. And it's very important because I have a very, very good friend that's a manager of mine, but she's a very dear friend. And I have someone here that wants to say something to that special, wonderful manager of mine, Nicola. Ginny. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Ginny.
I always told you that one day I'll manage to tell the world, or part of the world, how much I love you. And I would like you to come round, please. In a big trouble. Nicola! Babe. I just want you to say I love you. You marry me. You know I will. I can't hear you. Yeah. I think that's a yes.
Gorgeous, thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.
I'm so proud of you.
I can't believe you did that. Kenny, it's your show.
That meant so much to me. Come here. Do you know I started crying on stage?
I couldn't think of so emotional.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. I'm so proud of you guys.
Thank you, Pete. Oh, I got emotional on stage. You should have seen me. I was like, oh yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. That
was
incredible.
Thank you. Are you shaking?
Completely. Look at that.
And they all loved you. Did you see that? Oh, I'm so proud of you too, man. I'm so proud to be part of that moment.
Coming up next time, Pete and the kids relax in Marbella.
G'day, sport.
It's D-Day at last.
Are you aware you're getting divorced today?
Really?
And Andre Mania is taking over.
growing up in Hollywood, there's a lot of fakeness, and you never know why someone wants to be your friend. So yeah. I've really learned over the years what kind of people I want to surround myself with.
Coming up next, I'm getting exclusive access to the glamorous life of everyone's favourite heiress in Fernand Paris Hilton, exclusive to ITV2.